Linux Mint fans, good news. Mint 22.2 got some neat little upgrades that make the whole experience smoother, prettier, and a bit more modern. From a refreshed look, a blur-tastic login screen, to fingerprint login. Yes, finally. Let's check out what's new in Linux Mint 22.2. If you are coming from Mint 22.1, the first thing you'll notice is something feels different. It's not a dramatic makeover, but Mint's appearance has definitely been polished. Here is the deal. Libadvata is now patched to play nicely with themes. That means when you switch themes to change your accent color, GTK4 apps and even flat packs follow along without looking out of place. Since Mint relies a lot on flat packs, this is a big win. Oh, and the signature Mint Gray? It now has a hint of blue, giving it a cooler, more modern vibe. Subtle, but classy. Next up, the login screen. Mint added a slick blur effect to the panel and the dialog box, and honestly, it makes a big difference in polish. On top of that, user avatars are finally supported. If you share your computer with family, it is now way easier to spot your account at a glance. Sticky notes got a glow up too. They now have, rounded corners. Okay, not revolutionary, but here's the good part. They now run on Wayland. Since Linux is slowly moving towards a Wayland-only future, this is a welcome update. Plus, there is a nifty third-party open source app that lets you sync these notes with your Android smartphone. Pretty handy if you're juggling reminders across devices. Mint's own IPTV player, Hypnotics, also got some attention. If you didn't know already, Hypnotics lets you stream supported TV channels over the internet. This update adds theater mode and borderless playback for a more immersive experience, plus some under-the-hood performance improvements. I don't personally use it much, but if you do, let me know in the comments how well it works. Big one here. Linux Mint finally supports fingerprint logins. There is a new dedicated app that lets you set up your fingerprint for logging in, sudo commands, or even apps that need admin privileges. Sadly, I don't have a laptop with a fingerprint scanner anymore, so I couldn't test it out myself. But hey, if you do, give it a shot and let me know how well it works. The software manager also got a little refresh. Nothing earth-shattering, but the welcome screen looks cleaner now. The most useful addition? A help section that clearly explains the difference between flat pack packages and system packages. Perfect for beginners who get confused between the two. And one more thing, if an update requires a reboot, the update manager now shows a handy reboot button. Simple, but Mint is all about these thoughtful touches. And for those of you who care about the under-the-hood details, Mint 22.2 ships with Linux kernel 6.14 and uses the Ubuntu Noble package base. It will receive security updates all the way until 2029. The next point release, Mint 22.3, should land in around late 2026. So yeah, you got covered. So yeah, Linux Mint 22.2 doesn't completely change the way you use desktop. But that's the beauty of Mint, right? Subtle refinements, polish, and features that make everyday use just a little better. What do you think about these new changes? Excited about fingerprint login? Or still drooling over that blur effect on the login screen? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. And don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your fellow Linux friends, and subscribe to its force for more Linux goodness. See you in the next one, and as always, keep tinkering with Linux. Bye-bye.